Hi and welcome to the 17th episode of China Tools. My name is Dennis and I am from Hooked on Wood. In episode 16 I told you that it would be my last episode of this year. And the reason was that I had to make some gifts for Christmas and I wanted to build a little desk for my children. And although the desk is not entirely ready, I am on schedule. So I started to miss you guys and I thought, well, let's make an extra long China Tool video as a surprise. And if you want to see what this desk will look like, then follow me on Instagram, d.hookedonwood. I regularly show short impressions of my projects, short unboxing videos of new China tools that I received, and you are one of the first to know my new video topics. So follow me on Instagram, d.hookedonwood. And you can find a link on my YouTube channel page or on my website. You can also find a ranking among all the products I tested and free plans of my workbench and other projects on my website. I want to show you a few products in this episode. And one of the most requested items for a review are calipers. So I have two in a price range of $12 and $20 that I can tell you something about. And to test these calipers, I bought a seller box from Banggood that looks very nice, so we also want to take a closer look at that. I got a lot of questions about which product I used in my workbench videos, so I will also tell you something about that too. And I want to show you these push blocks, and finally I want to add some information about the clamping squares I showed you in episode 15. So let's start, and I hope you will enjoy this video. Calipers are one of the most requested items for a review, so I asked Banggood if they could send me some, and they did. And these are two calipers that are on the low end of the price spectrum, so let's see how they perform. Calipers are almost an essential tool in our workshop, so a useful and accurate caliper is a must-have in your shop. And to review these products, I needed a good reference. And although I have a good quality caliper to compare it with, I needed a more consistent reference. So to test these calipers, I ended up buying a setup box from Veritas, and I bought it for this purpose and to analyze future products. So I thought it would be a good investment. But when I tested it with my reference caliper, I got somewhat confused. The big setup block was pretty accurate according to my caliper, but other pieces are not. So I did not want to test these calipers with just three measurements, so I bought this box with setup blocks from Banggood. And I do not know if I will use these products for woodworking, but for those who work with metal and set up machines and tools, this can be a very helpful tool. So I want to show you just a little more of this box because I'm impressed by its build quality. It comes delivered in this nice wooden box, and before you show how beautiful they are, you have to unwrap the block from their foil. And luckily I had some help with small fingers. But look how nice these blocks are finished. No sharp edges, and I'm really impressed with it. Not industrial at all. There's a measurement certificate with it, with every single block's deviation in 1/1000th of a millimeter. And based on what I could measure, I think they are very accurate and deliver what they promise. And when you're looking for this kind of precise setup blocks, you will find out that these very accurate products cost a lot of money. I paid $60 for this Veritas set of 9 blocks, and these have an accuracy of 0.05 of a millimeter, so that's not even high grade. And this set did not even deliver. But looking for an alternative, I saw high grade sets for more than $200 and far above. So when I saw this set on Banggood for around $65, I thought it was reasonably priced. So when it arrived, I did not expect this finish and quality. They claim accuracy according to the DIN 8620 norm, which is lab quality and a very high standard. There's a measurement certificate with each block's deviation, and because the accuracy is way below the 1/1000th of a millimeter, I cannot check it. But based on the measurements I could make, the build quality and the price, I think this set is well worth its money. And this is my scoring card. So now we have useful reference blocks, we can review these calipers. And if you want to check calipers, two things are essential: accuracy and the build quality. And I want to start with the build quality. I got these two calipers from Banggood. This one cost $12 and this one cost $14. And of course, a taste of what is nice is very personal, but I prefer the looks of this one. They are both made of hardened steel and I found the overall impression decent. When I received them, I started to clean them carefully with a little bit of dry lubricant. And after cleaning it, it slides much better. And if you look a little bit closer to the caliper's fit and finish, I think they look very good for its price. The finish is good, although it's not reached the level of a more expensive one. This caliper costs around $60 and has a bit smoother finish, slides a bit better, and it feels a little bit more stable. But although the differences are relatively small, it is noticeable. This is another caliper I have, and this one costs $26. And if I compare the finish with this one, I do not see any difference. When I test a product, I start using it and see how long it takes to miss the product I usually use. And when I use this caliper, that moment came pretty fast. That had nothing to do with its accuracy, but more of the comfort to work with it. I did not get the right feeling with it. There's a bit of play at the front arms, and the sliding wheel has also just much to play for my taste, and it didn't slide that nice. So I changed it pretty quick with this caliper, and that worked much better. The arms are more stable, the sliding wheel feels more stable, and it slides better. These calipers have four functions. Outside measurements of an object between the front jaws, inner measurements with these jaws, and another possibility is to measure the depth with this pin, and you can measure the height with this front side. You could also transfer this measurement to a piece of wood or transfer to a ruler, so it's a very versatile tool. I will test its accuracy with these setup blocks. And first I want to try if the arms are parallel and straight. And the easiest way to do that is when you put a square block with some weight in between them. When the jaws are straight and parallel, the block should be stable in its place. And the second way is to slide something from the back to the front, and when the jaws are straight, the numbers should not change. And I was surprised to see that this $12 caliper passes this test so well. Not even my more expensive ones hold this block so steady. And the same counts for the other caliper from Banggood. The claimed accuracy is 0.04 millimeter, and I made 15 different measurements with these setup blocks, and from 50 to 9 millimeter it was 100% accurate. And from 8 millimeter down to 1 millimeter there was a deviation between 100 and 200 millimeter. I got this caliper from a friend of mine, and like I said, it costs $60 and it is calibrated, although the last time was 3 years ago. I did the same measurement with this one, and it was 100% accurate till 7 millimeters. Below the 7 millimeter, there were also some deviation between the 1 and 2 hundredths of a millimeter. So if I compare the accuracy of these two calipers, they score practically the same, which is pretty neat if you consider this one's price. And if I had no experience with this more expensive caliper, I think I would be very satisfied with this one. In fact, before I get that expensive caliper, I used this $26 caliper and I was pretty satisfied with it. But if I compare these, I prefer the Banggood one because it slides a little bit nicer, the arms are more stable and it is more accurate. So I think this one performs pretty good for just $12. The only drawback was the security of this pin. The screw does not manage to keep the pin secured in its place. So to summarize this caliper, I think you get a very good caliper for its price. It was really accurate in my test, more accurate than I thought would possible within this price range. My $60 caliper performs a little bit better on fit and finish and comfort to work with, but this caliper performance is excellent for its price. And this is my scoring card. I changed this caliper pretty fast, and when I started to work with it, it didn't slide that well. So when I wanted to test it, I wanted to give it one more try to see if I could make it slide smoother. And for that I disassembled it, but while doing this I lost a spring, and now it is broken, so I cannot make an accurate measurement anymore. And therefore I cannot rate this product. But based on my first experiences, I cannot say we had a very good relationship. Speaking of calipers, those who follow my channel know my son.
Hello, my daddy. Thumbs up!
So when I was searching Banggood for some new products, I came across this brass caliper. And the price was very friendly, so I bought one for myself and for my son. And mainly as a sort of joke to show my son that we have the same tools. And I did not expect back then that it returns out to be a very handy tool. I always wear it in my apron, and for quick measurements, this is my first choice. And there's a lot to say against it. It's made of brass, and that makes it perhaps too soft, especially if you put it in your apron with more tools. It has an engraved scale, and therefore it's not always good to read. The sliding mechanism is very basic. But on the other hand, with some ink, you can make the engravings better to read. It slides really smooth. It's fun to watch and hold in your hands. And it's always there if you need it. And it's pretty accurate. So this should not be your first choice for serious measurements when every tenth of a millimeter counts. But it is undoubtedly not the joke I thought it would be. And this is my scoring card. Next product is this set of pushbugs. It's a complete set in terms of you do not need much more in your workshop. And I consider this kind of products essential tools to make not only safer but also better cuts. It's made of plastic, not the cheapest plastic, but it certainly does not have the high-end look and feel. In the end, it is an affordable set, and that's not a bad thing. I cannot say I like the color, but if you look at it from a practical point of view, yes, it's easy to find them in your shop because of the color. And you can use this set on your bandsaw, your table saw, your router, your jointer, so it's not that strange that they will spread through your shop. If you look at these push blocks, the most important aspect is the comfort of holding them and the grip on the wood. And you see these blocks have two different shapes. For better and safer cuts on a table saw, you need a pressure in three directions. Down to the table saw, against the fence, and forward. And because of the shape, this happens more naturally. I use this one on the front, and when you lean on it, it pushes the wood in the direction of your fence. While this push block shape makes it easier to move the wood forward. I found the set on the small side at the beginning, especially if you compare it to the Incra push blocks I usually use. But after working with it for a while, I do not see it as a disadvantage, because they are a bit smaller and you can use them longer when you are cutting smaller pieces. And although I do not have little hands, they are not too small for me. Important is that they feel comfortable to work with and are stable enough. And I found them nice to work with on those aspects. Another important thing is how well they do stick on a piece of timber. And on the back they have a rubber substance that is denser than I'm used to. If I look at these Incra blocks, the rubber is much softer. And I bought these push blocks in my early years of woodworking, and these also have softer rubber. On the other hand, if we look at these micro jig push blocks, they also have hard rubber. So of course it all comes down on how much grip they produce, but how harder the rubber is, the longer the lifespan. Here I have a nice flat and smooth piece of timber, and if I put the different blocks on it and lift it at one side, you see the block slides off at some point. And with this easy test, you see that the Incra blocks really sticks to the timber. And that is the biggest strength of the Incra blocks. But one Incra block costs more than this whole set, so it would not be good if there was no difference. But if you move a piece of timber through your table saw, there's also some pressure downwards. And with the first test we did, that was not the case. So to visualize how sticky these blocks are, I measure how much force I could produce by pushing the timber against a pressure meter. Again, the Incra is the clear winner. But the Micro J Gripper and this set from Banggood performs the same. And the 120 Newton force with just one block on this smooth timber should be enough to even push wood with more tension through your table saw. If I compare it with this push block, which is comparable from a price point of view, you see that these Banggood blocks performs pretty good for the price. And because of the harder rubber, they also will be more durable. Another two items are these push sticks, and you can use them when you want to cut smaller pieces. You have to remember the 3 points of pressure, so you need 2 sticks for the best and safe results. With this so-called V-stick, you can push the piece of timber forwards, and because of the shape, you also put it downwards. It does not use a rubber underside to push the wood, but has a small heel that moves the block forward. With this push stick, you push the timber against the fence, and you always should keep this stick on the front side of your saw blade. I think the dimension of this push stick is perfect for a task, but I found the V-stick a bit too small for my hands, but also for my fence. The last item is this longer push block. And the best place to use this item is perhaps the joint, but only then in particular situations where a piece of timber is not too long. If that is the case, it's a very nice push block to use. In Europe, we have this safety item on our joint, and for that we have to put our hands or blocks over it, and therefore you cannot use this longer push block, at least not with the safety cover in its place. In the US, the safety cover slides away and you can use this push block. But even then, you should put pressure on a piece of wood on the outfeed side when you put it through your jointer, which is easier to do with 2 separate blocks, especially when your wood is longer. In the end, it's not a high-end set by it looks, but it is a complete and practical set to have in your workshop. It increases not only the safety in your workshop, but also makes your cuts better. And I can recommend this set for everyone who does not have these kind of products yet. It's an affordable set, can help you in many practical situations for better and safer cuts. And although the price is on the low end of the spectrum, the undersized material is pretty effective and gives a good and confident grip for most situations. And this is my scoring card. For my viewers, Banggood made a special offer on this set, and with a coupon code, which you can find in this video description, you get this set for only $90.99, which I believe is an amazing deal. I got some reactions to what kind of tool I use in the video of my workbench build, and I use it to align almost everything in that video, so I'd like to show it to you. It's a carbon steel ruler. Cost around $15 depending on its size, and if you look at the construction, I think it will last a lifetime. It's very heavy and it has a big knob to tighten the 2 parts together. That does not mean that it's a nice tool to watch. It's very industrial and the finish is not excellent. The front side is nicely finished, but the back is not. And I tried to sand it for 5 minutes to see if it would be better, but that does not matter that much. When it arrived, my first impressions were not great. I was a bit disappointed by its looks, and I thought it would be much too heavy for a ruler. The big knob covers the numbers of the scale when you have to read them, so you have to turn your head or ruler to read the scale entirely. It has a resolution of 1/10 of a millimeter, but for that I really need my reading glasses, and therefore it confronts me painfully that I became older. So the only positive thing at first sight was that it seems accurate. And I have to say that I got more rulers like this from Banggood, and perhaps I make a big ruler video next year. Let me know in the comments if you think that is a good idea. And although they all are a little bit different, they have the same function. But from all these rulers, these are the only 2 that survived in my shop. And if I have to choose between this ugly one and this high quality wood-packed ruler, I choose this one because I use it much more often. But I do not have to choose, and there are circumstances I prefer my woodpeckers, but this ruler turns out to be very nice to use. I like that it is so wide, so if you have to mark a point, you can keep the ruler still and draw a long enough line. Its size and weight slides easier alongside the edge of a piece of wood to draw a line. However, I prefer this kind of ruler for that purpose when possible. But what I like to do with this ruler is to align pieces. And for that I use it a lot when building my workbench. Its weight and size are beneficial for aligning things. It's easier to slide a piece of wood to the right spot. And because of the big front, it has the body to do so. With the big knob you can tighten it very quickly and strong, so even a heavy piece of wood will not change your settings. And because of the more oversized front, it will not slide under a piece what you want to align. So, to be short, what I thought would be its weakness turned out to be its strength. And I really start to love it for it. So it has become a tool that earned a permanent place in my workshop. And it's a shame it's not nicer finished, because that would make it even more attractive. And this is my scorecard. In episode 15 I showed you these corner clamps and I was very enthusiastic about it, and I think they offer an unbelievable quality for its price. I ordered 6 extra and recently I got them. But in this video I told you that I thought the scale was not wholly accurate. And when I watched my video later and I saw that my ruler that I hold it against was not completely flat on the table and therefore not well aligned with the corner clamp. So when I got my setup blocks, I wanted to recheck it, and you can see that the scale is very accurate. So I'm very sorry that my verdict was not accurate on that point. And if you are interested in this product, you have to watch episode 15. During the video upload, I saw that the price was still around $16 for a 100mm version, and I think that is an unbelievable low price for this quality. I bought myself a combination of 120 and 140mm because I found 100mm a little bit too small. Well, that was the last episode for this year. I hope you liked it and that you did not find it too long. Let me know in the comments. I want to wish everyone a very nice holiday. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and please stay safe. Till next year.